What's up, YouTube? Fair time again. Today we have a Yugioh cube. These are $15 at Target. So you break down the math, it's got 3 rares, 2 foils, 2 booster packs, 4 duelist packs. So it's worth its money. It is random packs. But where they, I don't want to say make a mistake, but you can kind of tell some of the things you're getting. So the foils here are face up, and your 2 packs that you're getting. So it's an 18 mega 10 pack, which we've been hit or miss with, and then a Shadow Spectres. I haven't opened a Shadow Spectres on camera or off camera, so that'll be a first for me. Not too worried about the rares, photos, and 20 cards, because it's essentially just going to be cards that were sent in. What company is this? Fairfield, yeah. So people send in their commons to get a couple pennies back, so they just throw them on here. But what you're looking for, honestly, is there's 4 duelist packs, because they're difficult to find now. Hard to find on even on eBay for decent. So 4 duelist packs, looking on eBay this past week, run around $12 to $20, depending on which duelist packs they are. So this cube itself, just with the duelist packs, makes up for it. And then you get a mega 10 pack and a random booster pack, so that's awesome. These have actually been hard to find, especially now with everybody having the mystery power boxes. These have kind of faded off in the distance. And this is the Target variants. Walmart has their own, and I don't like the Walmart one. Not at all. So we're gonna go ahead and crack this open once we figure out how. It's basically just a big old piece of tape around it. So it's a nice little cube, nice for storage. All right. Yes, exactly what I wanted, everybody. Best card in the deck, big old chunk of cardboard. Psych. So we got 1 Mega 10 pack, 1 Shadow Spectres, and our 4 Duelist packs we got. We didn't get gypped, we got 4. All right, first edition as well. Rivals of the Pharaoh. So those would be some interesting cards there. So for the random cards they give us, they are all discombobulated. Trying to situate them without looking. Not as easy as you would think. All right. So for the random cards, and just by looking at the side of them, I mean, that's, I think it is very piss poor on this company, as you can tell by the yellowness on the edges. Some of these cards are not even in decent condition. Some of them look like they were well played. Like, it's difficult to tell on my camera, but the corners of this one are peeling. So it's like, I'm glad the packs make up for the value of this, because probably can't resell any of these. Disturbance Strategy, Performer Pal Hip Hippo, Falling Current. Got a rare here, Rank Up Magic, Doom Double Force, Chronomaly Technology, Psy Station, Legendary Ocean, Wing Bean of a Giant Dragon. So some of these are out of old starter decks. Let's see, Swallowtail Butterspy, Magician's Robe. We got Card Safe Return, Yokozuna Sumo Spirit, Toll, Shift. Pretty sure this is out of the starter deck Yugi. No? It is. Look at this card. Let's see if we can get it on camera. Look how damaged that card is. Like, you can, in the reflection of the light, you can see the creases on this card. Like, it's like legit bent. It's horrible. Trash. Performance of Swords. Super Heavy Samurai, General Coral! From a Walking Dead, people there. Coral! Gentlemander, Vampire Orcus, the creator incarnate, Umi, Photon Cerberus for the rare, Reverse Buster, Tribe Shocking Virus, R Gen X Magma, Spiral Super Agent, 2 Gen X. So at least the foils are in good shape. But for these other 20 cards out here are just, I can't even like in good conscience even sell those in like a, just in a big box of random, like I couldn't do that to somebody. Like Fairfield, it was Fairfield, right? Yeah, Fairfield, trash. I'm very disappointed in that. I understand it's just 20 common cards, but Jesus. On to the Mag of 10 pack. This is a 2018. What do we got? FA City Grand Prix, Whip Crosser, Grappler Anger, Gravity Lash, World Legacy Landmark, Amazonas Spy, Altergeist, Silquitus. Nice, we did get a secret rare out of that pack. That's good. So we got a super rare and a secret. Squib Draw. Target rocket monster you control and destroy it. You can only activate one. So that'll be good with the new rocket deck coming out. Got the new rocket deck coming out later this month. So that'll be good support for that. Spellbook of Knowledge. Send to the graveyard either spellcaster monster you control or spellbook card from your hand or face up on the field. And if you do, draw 2 cards. I think I know a deck that'll work perfectly in. World Legacy, World Armor, Familiar Possessed Lina, Link Info Flyer, Paranites, Orbital Hydroland, Boral Cooling, and Muscle Medic. Spellbook of Knowledge, that's a very good card for your spellcaster decks. Alright, and on to Shadow Specters. So I'm not even sure which generation this was. I don't remember this one. Let's see what we get. Oh my. Alright. Bujing Boar. Night and Day Griffer. Ghost Trick Specter. Numbers Overlay Boost. Bujin Regalia, the Mirror. Bujin Ibis. Terrine Toothed. Not even gonna try it. Blue Destin. Battle Box and Rabbit Puncher. Right. Not too much interesting in that pack. Here we go. Rivals of the Pharaoh. Can we get a Silent Swordsman? It'd be nice. The Yugioh on the front. These are 5 card packs. Spirit Message, I. Blast Held by a Tribute. Temple of the Kings. Dedication through Light and Darkness. 1,000 Eyes, Restrict. Nice. Like, pretty much Battle City cards are there. Spirit Message was for Spirit Board. Destiny Board, sorry. Definitely some Battle City cards there. Hellpomer. Sangan. Unfortunately still banned. Blast Held by a Tribute. Spirit Message in, that's 2. Dragon Master Knight, Black Luster Soldier, and a Blue Eyes Ultimate. That's difficult to get out. Even with all the Blue Eyes support there is now, Blue Eyes Ultimate is still not an easy one to get on the field, let alone Black Luster Soldier as well. Green Gadget, Dark Necrofear. Spirit Message L, Necroface, and YZ Tank Dragon. three spirit messages. We need an F and an A. I doubt we're gonna pull two in one pack, but it'd be awesome. Spirit message A. I said it'd be awesome if we could get two spirit messages and we got a duplicate. Temple of the Kings, Tribute Burial, and Dragon Shrine. Nice packs. So like I said, these are $15 at Target. I'm still kind of upset about the common cards. Because I always feel like, you know, any cards, you know, coming out of a pack or anything, you know, sold nowadays is definitely easily resellable. Because there's always somebody that wants it, but those cards are damaged, like severely damaged. Like, I mean, they've got bends in them that are just, and it's hard to tell on camera, but it's like looking at it in person, you're just like, I wouldn't touch that with a 10-foot pole, you know? Very unfortunate. But we did get some good cards out of the Yugi pack. We almost got a full Destiny board. So that's gonna be it for today. Next week we're gonna be doing another deck profile. It seems to be better views. People are more interested in seeing different deck profiles. It works a little better than, yeah. So Rocket Revolt, looking at my calendar here, it comes out on the 16th, so that's next Friday. So we could probably pick it up Thursday, Friday, and we'll definitely do a review on that. I want to wait to see how well they work in the meta, because that'd probably be one I'd like to pick up three copies and run them. We'll see how that does. End of the month, we have the next, essentially the 2019 10. It's going to be the Gold Sarcophagus 10. And then Fist of the Gadgets comes out on the 23rd. So we do have a few more new products coming out this month that we'll definitely get here up on the channel for review. As always, anything you see on the board, except for Spellbook of Knowledge, definitely keeping that card. But anything else you see up here, you saw, and you want, just comment below, send me a message on eBay, and I will definitely send it your way, no problem. All right, and that is it, guys. Hit a thumbs up, subscribe, keep an eye out for the next one.